A DVD released in 2015 is suddenly gaining attention. A serious allegation is being raised in the footage from the NHK documentary program titled A Greenless Island.
撮影に入ったことはあったかな。裸で仕事させられんやったけどね、確か。いや、橋までこんな作業の仕方させよったかな、ってことはちょっと考えられるとね。黒く輝く素晴らしい石炭を掘る工夫の顔は、さすがに喜びに満ちています。これ、
橋間の映像ですか？
いやー、違うとつわね。キャップもつけとらんでしょ。
昔からこれはしとかんばんだ。わからんもん、おられんもん。他の明かりをつければ爆発するけどね、ガスがあるから。大体は私たちが落ちたときはもうピックで掘り寄ったもんね。釣り橋では掘り寄れやったもんね。ここは水平のところの中もんね。みんなこう勾配がこう引いてるからさ。これね、こう日が浅かところなかった。炭素がこうなっとったよけどね。それのところはこう平坂のところはなかったやって、みんな傾斜が勾配がこうついとったやって。
This program was broadcasted on NHK on November 17th, 1955. It was a valuable documentary on Hashima Mine, and it lives in the time of its golden age. However, 65 years after its broadcast, our investigation has revealed that some of the footage of Hashima Mine aired in this program was not true at all.
キャップランプを持たないで入港ということはありえないと思います。
ないでしょう、ランプは全然。ランプはないですね。少なくとも1メートル50センチぐらいはある。高さはですね、こんな張っていくようなところはないです。これはもう誰が見ても橋間じゃない。
Moreover, we have realized that the impact of this video during the 65 years was no small thing. As we unravel what is true or not, we have raised a question to the NHK producer of the program about the reason behind the production of the documentary.NHK Television Film was one of the flagship programs broadcasted in prime time at 7:10 p.m. The 20-minute documentary, A Greenless Island, was broadcasted in this time slot. A single photograph while being filmed has survived today. It shows the camera staff of the TV crew focused on some vibrant people of Hashima Island. Nonetheless,The finished product of the program actually turned out to be a surprise to the islanders.
Cap lamp を光らせながら地下深く入港、フライ港内での8時間労働が始まるのです。北九州でも有数の生産地として知られる端島は、島を中心として3キロ四方の海底に。
北九州何？
って言ってた。
うん、
さっきね。
うん、
北九州。
あ、
そう、
橋
島
北九州ですか？
いや、違う。
裸電球の形は綺麗にわかりますね。
あれこれも絶対モデルかなんかつけて痩せてる人集まって作ったってしか見えないです。
採山現場で狭いところに入るってことはまずないです。
Hashima Island, a coal mining island, was introduced in a documentary. Therefore, the scene of mining coal must have been the highlight of the footage. Nevertheless, a scene supposed to be in the inside of Hashima Mine was completely different from the actual one on the island. Until when the miners headed to work and entered the mine, it properly showed the true picture of Hashima Island. But as soon as the footage showed the inside of the underground mine, it switched to using footage of a place that is clearly not Hashima Island. One of the clues that has proved this fact was a cap lamp mounted on a helmet. People heading into the mine all wore cap lamps, but none of the miners shown here that are supposedly working in the mine were wearing cap lamps. Similarly, the work clothing was different too. People heading inside the mine were all wearing proper work clothing in reality, while the miners working in the mine here were mostly wearing only a loincloth. The colour and shape of their helmets were also different. The safety regulations for Hashima Mine of 1950 stipulated the wearing of cap lamps in Article 9, Clause 3 and Article 50, Clause 4. In addition, the official minutes of the Safety Committee in 1953 stipulated that anyone working naked must be prioritised to be educated and reported to each mine office. It is hard to suppose, based on common sense, that Mitsubishi Mining Co. Limited would have allowed NHK to film images that violated the safety regulations. Mr. Megumi Kurita has been working as a storyteller to pass on how it was like working at coal mines to future generations. He was hired and joined the mining section of Shinyu Coal Mine by Mitsubishi Mining Co. Limited, that also managed Hashima Mine. We asked him to watch the video.
これ小山やないですか。これは失礼かどころ小山なんやないですかね。これ大山やったら人数がまだ多いと思います。だいたいさっき超壁最短で120メーターぐらい、その中に70人おるんですよ。大山でこういうランプをつけんちゅうことはまだ考えられない。最短屈伸重点なんかはその通勤服兼作業着が一緒なんです。こんな格好で通勤はできませんから、これは大山やないと思うんで、ここだけのあれ見たらですね、そうやってランプをつけんで仕事するちゅうことがまだ。辛いやないですか、これ。辛いやったら小山ですよ。大山で人数がだいたい少ない。そして高さが、層の高さがこんなに短い、低いということをまず考え。とにかく大山を越え囲むということはまずない。
電球。
これ裸電球もね。
こんなん使わないですよね。うん、裸電球です。
裸電球。だいたい防爆が立ち寄ったでしょ。ほんで防爆型の電球にまた外に枠がありますもんね、本当は。
The lighting used in the mine then was an explosion-proof type that was considered relatively safe because the type had been upgraded and improved on a regular basis in order to prevent explosions due to methane gas that was produced from coal faces. Hashima Mine was classified as Class A, meaning a coal mine that was particularly rich in gas. Article 236 of the Safety Regulations for Coal Mines that was established in accordance with the Mine Safety Act stipulates that Class A coal mines shall use safety lighting apparatus typically used for mines. In other words, explosion-proof lighting fixtures shall be used in all Class A coal mines. Mitsubishi Mining Co. Ltd. introduced a training book, Coal Mine Guidebook, for all employees. It detailed the structures and how to use lighting apparatus.
照明をつけるってとこはちゃんと保安監督署の許可を得るんです。なかったですね。ああいう裸電球を直接使うということは。
It is hardly supposed that Hashima Mine, that carried out rigid safety measures, used the naked light bulbs as in the NHK video, because it was very dangerous. It is hard to believe that those were used in the mine.
炭素はコーラ取ってるからね。炭の掘ったところはこう開いたかったところはなかったやって、みんな傾斜が勾配がこっち取ってやって、僕はあの勾配なのって自然の石炭を掘ればさっさ流れていくことになってた、釣り橋でこう掘るようなことね。
こんな張っていくようなところはないです。三方から四方のあの石炭をみんなこうピックで掘ってたんですね。それでそれが四方にもう自然に落ちてくるわけです。あの四方に車庫斜めになってますから炭層が。
あの石炭の層が海底からずっと深く斜めにこう下がってますよね。傾斜がいろいろついてね。だから結局上の主構造と下の主構造とで、その上下を炭層をあの貫通させて上から下に流れるような最短の方法をしてるんですよ。だから結局あの傾斜が炭層がこうついてますから、石炭掘ったものが下に流れて下からこう出すような設備ですからね。映像では最短してるようなあの映像になってますけど、あんな最短のあれは端島の方ではなかったですよね。あれは発砲するための最短現場の穴掘り、ガスが多いから炭の中で葉っぱかけるってことはなかったから、ああいうこう映像が出たのはおかしいなと。端島じゃない、最短のための葉っぱ作業はなかったと。
This is a photo that showed some miners who actually worked at Hashima Mine. His face was covered by coal dust. But in the video, the miners were almost completely clean. Even their loincloths were as white as snow. This scene has made people who actually experienced Hashima Island to question whether this is factual.
汚れてたもんね。最短ならば真っ黒になるけんね。
最短現場に入った人なんか真っ黒なんです。目だけかって真っ黒なんです。あれ真っ白だよ、そういえばね。だからあれは結局映像のための作業じゃないかというような気はしますよね。
時計とか跳ねたのもんね。時計をはみ出した。庫内に入ることできるもんね。石炭が粉がいっぱい回るというから、単人が。
It is impossible that every scene in the footage was in fact factual. For what reason did NHK broadcast such unbelievable footage?Dr. Kikuo Matsui holds strong doubts about this video. He is a professor emeritus of Kyushu University and is also the honorary director of the Omita Coal Industry and Science Museum.
I use the energy to use very much energy, so in that area, I was able to use it at Hashima. So, usually, it's not the case. So, if you look at this, Hashima was working in such conditions in that area.いうようなところで非常に、別な意味で非常に、影響を及ぼすような映像になっているということも言えると思います。あそこの部分はちょっとあの、中にはめ込まれたという感じは受けます。 ですから NHK 側のそのあたりでの編集でどこかで、手に入れた映像をそこに組み込んだという可能性も出てきますね。
The official minutes of the Security Committee in 1955, which was also the year it was broadcasted, was recorded. In the minutes dated September 19th, that was held 2 months before the broadcast, the committee discussed practicing strict measures for the gas and coal dust explosion during the prevention period in the fall. Did Mitsubishi Mining Co. Ltd., that was paying full attention to safety issues, actually allow NHK to bring in lighting equipment to shoot inside the mine?
カメラが構内に入るというのは聞いたことないですもんね。
まず考えられないですね。だからあの映像はどこかの炭鉱の映像をつけてるんじゃないですか。
あれは橋間ではないと思います。あの筑豊の狛江炭鉱でやったやつを取っとるんだちゃうかなと、福岡に多くやったんですよ。筑豊炭鉱の小さい山が
羽島を取材に行ったけども断られたんですね。何としてでも撮りたい、どこかないだろうかっていうことを言ったところが筑豊、その先は筑豊であったら小さな炭鉱で今でもああいうことをやってるから炭鉱 の、 場所を現場を移したんだと。寝そべってた掘ってる写真と同じですよ。あれを動かしたっていうだけの話ですよ、うん。
There are two photos alleged to be Korean conscripted workers being worked like slaves on Gunkanjima. These photos have been repeatedly used as the symbol of the shameful history of Gunkanjima. Nonetheless, our research has revealed that both of these photos were taken around 1960 in a small-scale coal mine in Chikuho.They have nothing to do with the Korean conscripted workers. However, a victim who claimed to have been forced to work as if like a slave on Gunkanjima recounted their memories of those days as follows, despite the fact that there was no such fact.
I worked in a loincloth all year round. I was always wearing a loincloth and swinging a pickaxe.
I thought I would not be able to make it out alive.Because of the mining site was so narrow, but I just dug coal with my face down.
Why have there been such testimonies one after another? The mystery is finally being solved. The reason is that this footage of NHK has been shaping a negative image of Gunkanjima as an established fact since it was broadcasted in 1955. This image has been displayed at the National Memorial Museum of Forced Mobilization.Under Japanese occupation in South Korea. Even the Korean media has been repeatedly quoted and reported as a symbolic image of the slave labor on Hashima Island. Furthermore, in 2017, the Korean film titled Gunkanjima was released that was produced with a huge amount of money. In this film, footage of NHK was used as a reference point for historical facts.To spread a false negative image of Gunkanjima throughout the world. On October 16th, 2020, the NHK documentary was broadcasted in the Kyushu and Okinawa regions that reported on Hashima Mine, branding it as a negative legacy. The TV program is called Realization, Dodo, in the Island of Remembrance, a trembling legacy of history. Koko Kato, Managing Director of Industrial Heritage Information Center,also showed the video in question to the two directors of the TV program and asked their opinions. The NHK documentary short film titledA Greenless Island was broadcasted on November 17th, 1955. The footage of mining and transporting coals inside Hashima Mine were all videotaped at another place. NHK intentionally edited it to falsify the facts as if it had been taken at Hashima Mine. The footage was then used to spread an unlikely negative image as a historical fact throughout the world. How did this happen? NHK has a responsibility to investigate and answer our questions in good faith. We strongly demand NHK to acknowledge that it has spread misunderstanding around the world with false images and footage, and to correct its false reporting and to retrieve all the images and footage that have been disseminated.